is no more
than a dancing dog.
Than a dancing dog.
In the hands of a woman.
In the hands of a woman.
Purport. The restriction of association with such foolish persons is especially meant for those who are in the line of advancement in Krishna consciousness. Advancement in Krishna consciousness involves developing the qualities of truthfulness, cleanliness, mercy, gravity, intelligence in spiritual knowledge, simplicity, material opulence, fame, forgiveness, control of the mind and senses. All these qualities are to be manifest with the progress in Krishna consciousness. But if one associates with a sudra, a foolish person, who is like a dancing dog in the hands of a woman, then he cannot make any progress. Lord Chaitanya has advised that any person who is engaged in Krishna consciousness and who desires to pass beyond material nations must not associate himself with women or with persons interested in material enjoyment. For a person seeking advancement in Krishna consciousness, such association is more dangerous than suicide. Om Ajnana Timurandasya Gananjana Shalakaya Vachuramunipandina Tasmai Shri Gurave Namah Mancha Kaupatarubhyasya Kripa Sindhubhayevacha Paditanam Pavanevyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Nama. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Kadata Shiva Sadikor Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
So this Lord Kapila is speaking very powerful instructions here, not only to his mother, but to all of us. Of course, it's interesting here, he's speaking to his mother, and he's telling his mother not to associate with people who are like a dancing dog in the hands of a woman. And his mother is a woman, but his mother, of course, is a very exalted personality. She's not in the bodily conception of life. So, when you use the term dancing dog in the hands of a woman, this applies to men. And for a woman, that should not be a dancing dog in the hands of a man. So, situation works both ways. For men, they have to be careful how to associate with women. And for women, they have to be careful how to associate with men. So, association with the opposite sex is a very dangerous thing. And Lord Chaitanya has said here, for people who are on the path of trying to progress in Krishna consciousness, they have to be careful how to associate with the opposite sex. Lord Chaitanya was asked how to recognize a devotee. So Lord Chaitanya said, Asat Sangatya E Vaishnavacha Stri Sangha Ekasadu Krishna Bhaktiha. Asat Sangatya, the qualification of a devotee is that they give up the association of the asat. Asat means the temporary, the material. Asat Sangatya E Vaishnavacha. This is the first sign of a Vaishnava, a devotee. He's not materialistically inclined. He will associate only as much as necessary with the material world. Asat Sangha Chiyag Eva Stri Sangha. Stri Sangha means he gives up, he's not attracted to the opposite sex, the Stri, the women. A man should not be over-infatuated infatuated by the charm and the beauty of the opposite sex. Sri Sangha Eka Sadhu Krishna Bhakti Kara. So this is the nature of a devotee, that he will not associate with people who are interested in sense gratification. Women, generally we think of the opposite sex. A woman thinks of a man as being able to give her sense gratification. And similarly, a man also thinks of a woman as offering sense gratification. But for somebody on the path of Krishna consciousness, we have to see the opposite sex. We shouldn't just simply see them as objects for sense gratification, but we should see everyone as a spirit soul. We have to see them on the spiritual platform. We have to see them also as part and parcel of Krishna. So Lord Kapila is instructing his mother like this, that she has to become attached to She has to become attached to people who are not in the bodily conception of life. Devotional service begins on the Brahma-Buddha platform. In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Brahma-Buddha prasanatma nasochati. So, coming to the platform of Brahma-Buddha, this is the beginning. So on the Brahma Buddha platform, we don't think male, woman, we don't think of sense gratification. We simply see spirit soul. This is one spirit soul. One spirit soul may be in the body of a woman, another spirit soul is in the body of a man. And they're both working to become Krishna conscious. So they associate with that on the spiritual platform, not in the material platform. So, Lord Kapila is associating with his mother like that. He's directing his mother not to be bewildered by the demands of the senses. And the nature of the material mind is to think of sense gratification. We have a material body, and we think the goal of life is to satisfy the senses. But the senses are never satisfied. The senses will always be demanding attention. We will never satisfy the desires of the senses. So the same way materialistic people become infatuated with the attraction of the opposite sex, and they become controlled by them. So Krishna consciousness is meant to control the mind and senses. We're meant to cultivate the qualities of devotee. Prabhupada mentions in the purport some of the different qualities which should be cultivated by people practicing Krishna consciousness. Of course, begins with cleanliness. Satyam, Socham, Dayatapa. These are the pillars of religion. We have to cultivate these qualities. We have to cultivate control of the mind and senses. Due to conditioned life, we identify with the material body. But we have to purify that conditioning. Conditioned soul can be purified by hearing the knowledge of Krishna consciousness. The more we hear the knowledge of Krishna consciousness, then we're reminded of our actual spiritual position. So, Lord Kapila is pointing out to us that we shouldn't become a dancing dog. In other words, you become controlled by the attraction of the opposite sex. the opposite sex of that nature, that they appear attractive to the person in conditioned life. The man is attractive to the woman, in the same way the woman is attractive to the man. So this is conditioned life. We are thinking that this man is going to give me some comfort, some shelter, some sense gratification. In the same way, the man is thinking the woman will offer some service and take care for me and provide for me nice words and comfort. And so we are thinking, trying to make the body comfortable, trying to find a comfortable, happy situation. But we should understand, the temporary nature of the material world, that you cannot be happy, cannot remain in this condition in the material world for long. You come together in the course of time, and in the course of time, you're separated. We have to understand that real happiness is not found in the body. The real happiness is found in the soul. So Lord Kapila is encouraging his mother not to try to find the temporary pleasure of life through the senses and through the body, but to experience spiritual pleasure, to discover our spiritual pleasure. To do that, of course, she has to take the association of spiritually inclined people. And so there's two kinds of association. You can associate with materialists, and you can associate with people who are on the spiritual path. If you associate with the materialists, then you become affected, you become influenced by their consciousness. So it is said, Mahatsevam Dvaram Ahurvimoktes Tamo Dvaram Yoshitam Sangi Sangam. When you serve the Mahatmas, the great souls, then it opens the doors to liberation. But when you serve the objects of sense gratification in the form of the opposite sex, Yoshitam Sangi Sangam, then it opens the doors to ignorance and hell. Tamodvara, the doors to hell are open. Right? In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna speaks that there are three gates to hell: lust, anger, and greed. And every sane man will try to avoid these gates of hell. So we have to avoid these gates of hell by association. Everything comes by association. If we associate with the right people, then you can get the right benefit. You can be saved from the hellish experience. But if we follow the materialistic path, you follow the path of the materialists, you become like them. Described to become a dancing dog in the hands of a woman. Just like some women, they will keep a dog and they will make the dog dance, right? They feed the dog, they will say, and the dog has to get up on its back legs, and the dog has to wag its tail. And then this way the dog has to give some pleasure to the woman, and then the woman will feed the dog. So the same way men become also like dancing dogs in the hands of the women. Their business is just simply to please the women, to give pleasure to the senses of the woman. And in this way the man is also feeling some pleasure. The man is working very hard, making money, and the woman is taking the money. So it's stated, there's a verse in the Tulsi Ramayana, in the Tulsidas Ramayana, it says, Dinkadakini Ratkabagini Palak Palak Rahukush. Dinkadakini. So like this is describing the nature of the materialistic aspect, material life, how he's struggling. In the daytime, he has to work hard to make money. So it's like a type, like the chapel, like a tiger. Tiger also eats the blood. So in the same way, the man, he has to go out and work all day, give his blood, make money, feed the family. And then at night also, he has to come. He has to satisfy the way of sex. And again, he needs to give blood. So in the daytime, like a tiger, and at night, like a daytime, like a jackal, and at night, like a tiger. The only business is sucking the blood. So materialistic life is like that, just blood-sucking business. But somebody who is awakened to self-realization, Krishna consciousness, then they're careful, and then they protect themselves from that kind of situation. So Lord